Den der. Jeg skal lige have fat i den her.
All right, welcome back to the base jumping diary, or my base jumping diary. I'm still wearing the same t-shirt as last week. I don't really see a reason to change a t-shirt if it's not dirty. So it looks good on me and I'm still wearing it. And also today I'm wearing these Stars and Stripes pants, pretty fucking badass. I know, Marie agrees. Yeah, see, she says yes. Back to the topic. Welcome to the first episode. As it said, my very first base jump. You just saw it. That was my very first base jump right there. My mentor's camera went out of battery 30 seconds before I jumped. I was just about to go over the railing and jump. Yeah, there's absolutely no documentation of me doing my first base jump ever. It doesn't really matter because I still have it. I saw it and I still have it inside my brain. So that's all good. Luckily, this was late afternoon. We went back the next morning and had some more days there. So we did a few extra jumps there, and yeah, it became a really special trip. First base jumps is something everyone remembers, that's for sure. As you see, we went back next morning, sneaking up there. Back then, this bridge in southern France wasn't as open as it was today. Today, the cops don't really care about it. Back then it was super intense. You really had to look out for every car, look out for the cops, dodge them, only jump early morning, late evening, just before the sun sets and sunrises, stuff like that. Yeah, that made it just a bit more wow. Nevertheless, I had a really good trip. Before this trip, I did a lot of skydiving. It was just after the military. Did a lot of skydiving, very intensely, trained only for base jumping, tracking, having unheading openings, flying big canopies, landing them exactly where I wanted to land them, all that stuff. That was all I trained for the first many jumps. Before this jump, I went on a trip to Spain with my mentor where we did like 50 jumps, again, just training for this. And then when he said, I think you're ready, we went to France and I did it. Still today, I'm still thinking about him often because he is the most safe base jumper I've ever met. And that definitely, I'm not saying I'm the safest guy in the world, but it's definitely made it's definitely made an effect on me that having him teach me taught me a lot about safety as well. I have done a lot of stupid shit. Most base jumpers have. We don't always think, but with time comes more reasonable thinking. So I tend to think that I've become way more safe and slow jumper today than I was back then. But you will see that in the coming videos, that's for sure. All right, enough of all this talking. Time to get back to southern France. Here you see first jump, where my mentor gives me a static line, a PCA, making the canopy open really quick. Nice and safe way to have a first jump and a second jump as well. Third jump,
I got it.
Me first time going handheld, meaning I actually opened the canopy myself without help from anyone else.
3, 2, 1. Nice!
Fourth jump, exactly the same as the third. Going handheld, trying to find a good boxman position. I was a bit head high on the third one. So fourth one, trying to sort out those small things and make it even safer. The thing I'm probably being asked the most, besides how do you land your wingsuit, is weren't you scared on your first jump? And to be honest with you, I actually wasn't. I was nervous like I am on every jump, but somehow I felt really calm and it felt like the most natural thing in the world to be there. Oh, I know it sounds weird, but it felt really chill and it felt like this was the right thing, you know. I had trained for this and I felt ready, I felt prepared, so it was very calm and I really soaked it in and it was just beautiful. Yeah, so I wasn't really scared, to be honest. All right, that's it for this week. I hope you liked it. Next week I will be back with something new. I don't know what yet because I haven't looked at the external hard drive, but we'll see. Maybe it'll be good, maybe not. Maybe I'll still be wearing the same shirt. Maybe I'll still be wearing these bad boys. Who knows? Thank you for watching.